All right, so here we are again. Now, keep in balance at all times. Like I said, keep your head on a swivel. You want to have that peripheral vision, man. And when you have certain thoughts come through your head that want to make fun of people or that want to make you feel sad or make you want to feel like a dumb shit, thoughts that say, you shouldn't have said that, you shouldn't have done that, just watch them go by, man. And use that Kundalini experience where you got your root chakra and it's that feeling like when you're half asleep, ready to nod off on your bed, you're doing your meditation on your bed. It's that half a feeling sleep, man. You're so relaxed inside, even though you're up and you're out and you're walking through the house and talking and doing all this other stuff. You're so relaxed inside that your Kundalini can start to rise up. It's called the Mountain Dew, and this is the eternal life oil that gives you your eternal life, but you got to put your claymolein in also in order to claim your eternal life. But it's a constant practice of that balance, man. Constant practice of that balance, that peripheral vision. You're constantly training yourself like you're walking through the planet, you're walking through your house like you're driving your car. It's that same feeling. So all you got to do is memorize that feeling. Feel what it feels like when you're driving your car all the time. You're constantly feeling that there's something behind you, that there's something that might come up on the side of you, that there's something that might show up around the corner. So this is actually healthy to do because this keeps you from getting locked in your mind. You'll be walking through your house and you stub your toe and cut your toe wide open. You'll quit doing that instantly when you start looking around and being relaxed inside. So like I said, your Kundalini starts to rise up from your root chakra, becomes Mountain Dew. You'll learn that from this book called The Salts of the Zodiac, or Zodiac and the Salts of Salvation. And that's this book right here. See? As you can see, yes, I wrote the whole book and put my own notes on it. And I usually, when I read books, and I get deep into them, it looks like this. I write books right on top of everything. So as you can see, I connect the words and everything. I write a book right on top of another book. Here's a Joseph Campbell book called The Outer Reaches of Outer Space. Joseph Campbell right there. This one helped me see that I don't have to die. I can have eternal life. Okay, let me see. As you can see, I write books on top of books. I redeveloped the language. I write words on top of words and all that. And I study books. I don't just read them. I study them, man. And I get so heavily involved with it. So I wear myself out sometimes. I have to take a break. But Joseph Campbell kept saying in his book, everyone must die, everyone must die. And all of a sudden the revelation came in, came to me. No, we don't have to die. We don't have to die. And I connected it to that claim of lien, man. Private maritime law. Cha-ching, baby. All right.